Hey guys, it's SmokeMonster, and today we're going to look at the new Runahead mode in RetroArch, which is also referred to as lag-free mode or no-lag mode. What this feature does is it allows you to get rid of the internal latency that's built into some of these games. Like, most people aren't aware of this, but I found that Super Nintendo and Genesis games have 1 to 3 frames of lag baked into the game itself, so that if you're going to jump in a game, for example, you hit the jump button and it takes 3 frames before the game itself reacts. So regardless of anything else in your setup, you're getting a little latency there. And this new feature in RetroArch allows you to essentially jump ahead 3 frames to catch up for that baked-in lag. And you can use it with any core that supports save states. And it's really easy to set up. You do have to configure it specifically for each game. So every single game that you play will have a different amount of frames that you need to advance. And it's really easy to figure out how to do that, and it just takes a second when you launch the game, and I'll show you how to do that. So let's go check that out. Okay, so I have RetroArch open, and before I enable the Runahead mode, I need to calculate how many frames of lag, if any, the game that I want to play has built into it. And so every game that you want to play is going to have a different frame advance setting, but the method for determining it is the same for every game and for every core. So I'm going to use Space Megaforce as an example for the Super Nintendo, also known as Superlest. So to determine how many frames of lag a game has, you want to start a new game. And while the game is running, not paused, you want to hit P. And that pauses the emulation of the system, but the game itself is still running, which you can advance the emulation by one frame at a time by hitting the K button on your keyboard. As you can see, the game is still running. So to know how much input latency a game has, I need to hit a button and see how long it takes the game to react. So for a platformer, you might hit jump. Since this is a shooter, I'm going to hold down fire. And if there was no input latency, then on the next frame, it would register a fire. But let's see how many frames Space Megaforce has. So I'm holding down fire. I'm going to advance 1 frame. You can see nothing happen. On the 2nd frame, it starts the fire. So it had 1 frame of input latency. And I'll do that again so you can see what I mean. So I'm going to advance a few frames. Now I'm going to hold down fire and advance 1 frame, no reaction. On the 2nd frame, you have a fire registered. So what that tells me is there's 1 frame of input latency. So now I'm going to exit back to the menu by hitting Start and Select. And you want to go to the settings for latency, which is a new option they've added in one of the recent updates to RetroArch. You want to enable run ahead to reduce latency. We calculated 1 frame to run ahead for Space Megaforce. And then there's an option to run ahead, use second instance. And what this does is if you have a powerful enough computer, you want to enable this to get a better performance out of the game, because this will have a second instance of RetroArch running, calculating all of the frame advance things while you play it back in the first window. So if you run into performance problems, you want to disable this. But now let's go back into the game, pause it again, and now let's repeat that. I'm going to hold down fire, advance 1 frame, and you can see that it fires on that 1st frame. So now there's 0 input latency, at least on the emulator side. So we've looked at Space Megaforce on the Super Nintendo. Now let's compare a Sega Genesis game and see how it fares. Okay, so we looked at Space Megaforce on the Super Nintendo. Now let's compare that to Sonic 2 for the Sega Genesis. So it's the same process. I want to start a new game. And then while the game is running, I want to pause the emulation. And now I'm going to hold down the jump button and see how many frames it takes for Sonic to react. So I'm going to advance 1 frame at a time using the K button on the keyboard. There's 1 frame. And on the 2nd frame, he reacts. So again, here's another game with one frame of input latency that we can compensate for using the same method as I showed with Space Megaforce. Okay, so far so good. 1 frame of input latency isn't too bad. Now let's look at one of the offenders in this aspect, Mortal Kombat 2 for the Super Nintendo. This is a game that people have been complaining about how laggy it is since it was released back in the 90s. So I'm just going to start a new game. And once the game is running, I want to pause the emulation. Alright, so I'm Liu Kang. I'm going to hold down punch and advance the frames until he reacts. I'll count them out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So there were 4 frames there. I found that with Mortal Kombat 2, it's you average around 3 frames of an input latency. I think it depends on where you are in your stance as to where it reacts to the buttons. So right there we saw 4 frames. But let me just jump to a few different points and we'll count it out again. All right, so I paused it. I'm holding punch. 1, 2, 3, 4. So there you saw it was 3 frames of input latency. I'll go to another position. All right. 1, 2, 3, 4. So it was 3 frames there. So I'm pretty sure that Mortal Kombat 2 has baked into it 3 frames of input latency, which for a tight fighting game is pretty much going to make it unplayable, especially when you add in controller latency and the latency that your computer is adding, depending on how powerful it is. So you have 3 frames just to start off with that you're behind. So people were right about the Super Nintendo Mortal Kombat 2 is just a lag fest. And so everybody used to fight about which version of Mortal Kombat and Mortal Kombat 2 was the superior version back in the day, Super Nintendo or Genesis. Let's compare that 3 frames of lag Super Nintendo Mortal Kombat 2 to Mortal Kombat 2 on the Sega Genesis. So I'm going to load a new game. You can definitely see the reduction in colors. Same character. And let me pause the emulation. I'm going to hold down punch and count the frames. 1, 2. So you saw there's 1 frame of input latency on Mortal Kombat 2. And I'll repeat that again just to be sure. Okay, I'm going to count it again. I'm Liu Kang punching. 1, 2. And he punches. So you have 2 frames less of input lag on the Sega Genesis version of Mortal Kombat 2 compared to Super Nintendo, which is pretty significant. And if you want to tighten that up, you can completely eliminate the input lag by doing a run ahead of 1 frame in RetroArch. So that's a pretty cool application of it. And finally, I'll show one more game, 1941 Counterattack for the Super Graphics, which is a very tightly playing and nice controlling shoot 'em up. So we'll load up our game. We'll pause the emulation. I'm going to hold down fire and advance the frames. So 1, 2. So there's 1 frame of input latency, which might help to explain why this game controls so nicely, just like Super Lest. Okay, so we looked at 5 games and I showed you how to completely eliminate their built-in lag, the input latency that's in the game code itself, which you're going to experience even on original hardware connected to a CRT TV and everything. There's no way to get around that programmed-in latency, except to use RetroArch and to use Runahead. So on a theoretical computer that was perfect in every way, the graphics card was supported perfectly in RetroArch, and your CPU wasn't introducing any lag, and if your computer was hooked up to a CRT TV, you could theoretically have a better experience in emulation than on the real hardware. In practice, I don't think that that's true, and I'm definitely not going to be testing it. I always prefer to play on the real hardware, as do most people. But this is a cool feature, and if anything, it allows you to scientifically know exactly how many frames of lag are baked into the games that you're trying to play. So for Mortal Kombat 2, you've got 3 frames of lag. It's just terrible. So people were right about that game for all of these years. I generally only use emulation for like expensive arcade hardware that I know I'm never going to own. And for that, this feature is really cool. If you are using it for console emulation, this is definitely something you want to check out. And I don't know if they'll be adding this feature support for this into lower powered systems like RetroArch or Raspberry Pi or something like that, but you can keep a heads up for it. And yeah, cool feature, theoretically improves the games. Let me know what you guys think, what you're going to use it for. And I wanted to thank again my patrons who are supporting me through Patreon. This is an early access video that all of my patrons have access to. They also have an invitation to my elite exclusive Discord chat group. And they have access to my Patreon-only videos, which I post there. So a huge thank you to them. Every dollar helps. It's all going back into the channel, and I'm already getting some cool stuff to improve the quality. So thanks for watching. Please like the video if you enjoyed it, and subscribe. Ring that bell icon like Hector Salamanca if you want to be notified when I do my live streams, which I do every week on Saturday at 10 p.m. Eastern time. And so, yeah, it's Smoke Monster, and I'll catch you guys next time. Thanks for watching.